So hi everyone, welcome back to MAD. So today we have Vedant Gupta with us, who got All India rank 5 in GATE, and his branch was aerospace engineering. So Vedant, just a brief introduction about yourself. From where did you did a your bachelor's, and from where you did your schooling and everything?
Sure. So as you guys know, my name is Vedant Gupta, and currently I am a final year student of BTech Aeronautical Engineering at Rajasthan Technical University, Kota. Yes, I did get All India rank 5 in GATE Aerospace 2021. I belong to the city of Ahmedabad in Gujarat, and I look forward to doing a Master's of Technology in Aerospace Engineering.
Okay. Thanks, Vedant. So I think first question, a very good rank in under 10, right? So
yes.
From which year did you start preparing for GATE? Because some people have that, okay, to get this good rank, I should start in second year, third year, final year. So what was your strategy?
Yeah, so basically, to be honest, I started in really late. Like I specifically remember the date when I started. I began my studies specifically for GATE on July 8th, 2020. So it was in my final year. Okay. And I was thinking about options right from third year. But, I kept canceling other stuff, and it condensed into, preparing for GATE. So, yeah, that's about it.
So you started in the final year, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. Now, second thing, did you did everything on your own, or there was any coaching? Obviously, I think during the COVID situation, you were not able to go to any classroom programs. So how are you dealing with that?
Voice just got.
So my voice got.
Your voice got cut, actually. So if you just.
Okay, no problem. I will mention again. Okay, thank you for that answer, Vedant. Yeah. So my next question was, did you went for any coaching? Obviously, yeah. I think that in 2020, due to COVID situation, the coaching classes might not be there face to face. So any online coaching or any case, any test series that you joined?
Right. Yeah, so my preparation was done by myself. It was a self-preparation strategy. But indeed, I did take up a coaching for online test series. It was done by IITN's GATE Classes Bangalore, or IGC Bangalore. So those guys took the extended the online test series set from them, which included everything right from the topic level tests all the way up to the full mock tests. And apart from that, I also took a worksheet material and a mock test series from Gating Aerospace. Mm-hmm. So they are not exactly a coaching class. They're just a service provider that they basically just prepare some questions and do the guidance for GATE. So these two. Okay. But preparation was a self-done strategy.
Okay, understood.
Yeah.
So I think, again, like, let's see through eyes of a newcomer who is like in third year and final year. So what was your recommendation? Is like coaching mandatory? Is it definitely necessary, or someone can do by self-study, and how beneficial those test series are? So what is your take on that?
Right. Well, if anyone is asking, is GATE Aerospace really, does it require coaching? I'll say no, because the thing is, most of the basics that go into any general BTech in aeronautical or aerospace in any university in India, that covers most of the things that are required for GATE. And apart from that, mathematics and aptitude are really easy. So as a class point of view, no, it is not entirely required. But if people have different choices. So my preparation, what I did, every kind of study, every subject I did from those core classic textbooks. So a few people, they face a few issues. Sometimes textbooks aren't that friendly for them. So in that case, definitely classes are fine. But yes, indeed, you mentioned about the test series. That is a must. I'll recommend to any junior that they should do at least 15 full mock tests and at least, 30 to 40 topic and subject level tests, so that they are thorough with all these kind of things. So specifically about my coaching IGC, they were really awesome. The test series was nicely structured, and they did a good counseling as well. And I was just a test series student, but I they gave me the support that they would give to any general classroom student. So those kind of things really helped me put my GATE strategy into motion. And once again, coaching is not entirely required, but yes, tests they are highly required.
Understood, understood. Now coming to your branch, I'm from mechanical engineering, so I might not be knowing the subjects in aerospace engineering, but what are the important subjects that the viewers who are from aerospace engineering should be focusing on? Plus, what are the standard textbooks that you would like to highlight?
Sure. So I'll just quickly tell about all the subjects in GATE aerospace particularly. So the first and foremost is of course mathematics. I mean that is common to every branch. So therein probably I did from the book by Made Easy and also few questions from H.K. Das and Erwin and Krycek. So these Erwin Krycek and H.K. Das are more than enough for mathematics because they give a really nice conceptual layout. Now coming into the core aerospace subjects, the first one is aerodynamics. That includes three parts. First is fluid mechanics, then is incompressible aerodynamics, and then is compressible aerodynamics. So for the fluid mechanics part, they can study from Simbala or from Som Biswas and Chakrabarty. Then aerodynamics, well, I mean it's a saying in aerospace people that there is only one Bible for aerodynamics, that is J.D. Anderson, the book by Dr. J.D. Anderson. So that is like amazing book which has all the concepts and small notes that can really help in GATE. Even for compressible flow, aerodynamics by J.D. Anderson is the best one to go in for. Next, probably aerospace propulsion is a very interesting and very important subject for GATE point of view. So that I did from the book by Professor V. Ganeshan. He was a professor at IIT Madras, and his book is really awesome. It covers all the concepts of thermodynamics, right from cycle studies all the way to those peculiar turbo machinery things that are part of the GATE syllabus. And there is a small portion from rocket propulsion as well. So that I did mainly from material on the net or a few other books like the book on rocket propulsion by Sutton and Biblars. So that was real. That's not much of a trouble actually. Then the third one is which contains probably the most marks in GATE, that is aircraft structures. That again has three portions. For the first is strength of materials or SOM, as a lot of so common term SOM, and then there is aircraft structures which deals with specifically structures to do with aircraft, and then there's vibration engineering. So for SOM I did from GATE. That was more than sufficient. It was a great book. For aircraft structures, I did from a book called T.H.G. Maxson. The author's name is T.H.G. Maxson. So therein, those topics like thin-walled structures and all those kind of. So that's really substantially and expansively covered. And for vibration engineering, well, I mean, I struggled in vibrations a little. So I took from two books. One I did from Grover, and second I did from S.S. Rao. So for structures, it is enough. But yeah, one has to put in more questions than any other subject because structures has the most weightage and the most variety of questions. Then moving on, we had flight mechanics, which again had two parts. First is aircraft performance, and the second is aircraft stability and control. For the performance part, I did from another book by J.D. Anderson, the same author, but he has set many books for different subjects. And for stability, I did by like from a book by R.C. Nelson. So that was it. And yeah, we have one another subject which is space dynamics, but more mostly one or maximum two questions come in GATE. So that I did just from sources on the on the net, the NASA website mainly.
Okay, yeah. So thanks for a very detailed explanation. I think for the aerospace guys, these books definitely would help. So so
Definitely.
far we have discussed that, okay, you started in your final year, you did the test series. Coaching is not mandatory as such. You can do a self-preparation, and then you have the details of all the books. Now, this was the strategy preparing for the exam. Now, on the examination day, in the examination hall, what was your strategy to solve the paper? Like they are one mark paper, two mark paper, aptitude, and the technical one. So how did you started and how did you went on?
So coming about talking about the paper pattern and what we have to do in the examination hall, well, generally what was expected from GATE was that they'll give in a same old fashion the paper. So starting with GA, then with one markers, and then with two markers. So what my strategy was, what was to do in this very fashion. But this year, I mean, they mixed it all up really. I mean, it was a real mix up because first they gave GA, that was fine. But then all the questions were mixed. So, like, the first question came for 2 marks and then a series of questions for 1 marks and then 2 marks. So, it was all jumbled up. So, I really had no choice in that. So, I thought I'll stick with the question numbers as they come. GA, first doing GA is really nice because it's, as I mentioned, very simple and lets the flow settle in. So I did aptitude first in probably 10 to 11 minutes, and then I moved to core part. And there, my strategy was to like when one is reading the question. So my thing is that while reading it and after 10 seconds, if I'm not, if something does not click in my mind, the proper solution steps, so I will just drop it. So if you think more on that, so that will waste a lot of time, and time is really, really precious in GATE. And not only that, but also I practiced the GATE calculator really nicely because that can make or break the day. So even I installed it on my phone actually. So whenever I was doing any calculations, even at the Kirana store, if I was doing calculation, I did it on the GATE calculator. So that really helped me out. And point to all the aspirants that focus on the calculator part. So yeah, by the end I had about 15 questions left and about 25 minutes left. 15 questions which I had not touched at all right from the start. So in 25 minutes I figured them all out, and that's the thing. But yeah, the core of the strategy was that don't waste much time on one question which you are not understanding.
Understood. So basically, you went with the flow. You didn't waste it like
Absolutely.
more than 10 seconds of time if you kind of it didn't click it. And then
Right.
you use the you practice basically the calculator that is there, right? Okay, good point. Now, because you got only rank 5, so people might think that okay, Vedant was putting too much of time every day in studying and very, very serious. So, like, did you do any extracurricular? How much time every day you were putting while preparing?
Sure. So, I mean, well, the good thing that happened with us was that this particular year was that we had the lockdown. I mean, of course, the reasons were pretty bad, but it turned out at some positive that we had more time at home, that too. And I mean, college online classes, they generally take around 3 to 4 hours of the day. But if it were offline, then it takes around 5 to 6 hours of my day. So that helped me, gather a lot of time. So what my strategy was initially, while, reading from the books and making notes and practicing from worksheets, I took around 6 to 7 hours a day, and I was just doing that. But later on, I just kept on reducing the time, and just and that was also due to some factors like college exams, online exams, and some project related stuff, and also to just keep my mind off. And especially in January time, when I was just appearing for my full mock test, all the time that went in was to give the mock test and just read the notes before that, and then after the test, working on my mistakes for 1 hour. So at the end of the during the end, I mean, I did not spend much time studying. And talking of extracurricular, well, if I were at my college, I would definitely go and play badminton or something TT with my friends. But here at home, I made sure, in fact, that I go for a walk. Or at least in the nearby garden, and I did some skipping, did some jogging, did some exercises just to keep the blood moving. So that's really, really important. I mean, I made sure never ever to miss that. I mean, it's just about 45 minutes a day, to probably maximum 1 hour a day. So I did that, and that's really that helped me a lot. That's too much for what I help.
I think maybe the last question is on the revision part. So how did you
Yeah.
make your notes? Were it like a two lengthy notes or short notes, and what was your strategy in revision?
Right. So, well, I'd like to point out a really important thing, especially in terms of aerospace. More or less, see the subjects, they are, the syllabus is not that, wide as is in the case of GATE Mechanical or probably GATE CS. So the subjects, they are small. And what my thing was to condense all the notes in just one notebook. So I had a like 200, 220 page, the full scale A4 notebook, and all my notes were therein. So I did not, have to look for other stuff. So And in those notes, I made sure not to use, those long derivations and long steps and long statements. So all the definitions and anything which I wrote, it was maximum 2 to 3 lines or 1 or 2 sentences basically. And all the important formula, I used to cover it in a box. And so it was just about keeping the right stuff, because during the end when I'll be revising, so if I spent my time, looking at some other stuff, some other non-important stuff, so it will be a wastage. So to avoid that, I just kept it short, kept it brief.
Okay, understood. Thanks. So, what are your last closing comments for anyone who is preparing for GET from aerospace engineering and they are in their third year, final years, or maybe in the second year?
Yeah. So, indeed, I mean, the only thing I'd like to say is that, whoever wants to be in the aerospace industry has to be really passionate about it, because it is a sort of different line altogether. So that same passion has to be reflected in the GATE preparation as well. I mean, if you consider it as a burden, some points definitely they are a little burdensome, but try to enjoy the concepts and try to maximize what we can, learn out of those books. So that will be the only criteria. And GATE Aerospace, it is easy. I mean, if you're just thorough with the concepts, some practice, and you can easily crack the top 50. So my piece of advice would be to keep the passion going and keep the continuity on. I mean, we always read it with the with the idea that continued focus, continued effort. So that is really, really important. So yeah, that's there. Just keep the passion, be energetic, be enthusiastic about studying for it, because indeed it has the, it will lead you to a good career in aerospace. Because right from bachelor's, in India, the acceptance of aerospace engineers which only have a bachelor's degree is not that high. So if you do a master's, definitely job opportunities will increase, and not only that, research opportunities will increase. So it will be a all in all good package if they appear for GATE. So yeah, keep the passion on and keep continued efforts.
Yeah. Sure, Vedant, thanks for sharing all this thing. And I think once your counseling is done and you have got an offer from any of the colleges, we will kind of again
Right.
try to get in touch with you. And like,
Sure, 100%. And thanks
meanwhile,
for having me. It's really nice to, have to speak with all of you.
sure, thank you, thank you. So yeah, guys, thanks for watching. If you have any questions, please feel free to post in the comment section. And I will ask Vedant to share the books list with me, and I will put that down in the comment section as well. It might be helpful for someone who is preparing for GATE and is the as in the aerospace engineering part, and we will try to get more videos from the top of 2021. So thank you. Have a great day. Bye-bye.